velkým potěšením přivítat Vasilie Sinajského poprvé na zkoušce v roli našeho šéf-dirigenta. So Vasily, welcome the position for the first time.
Thank you. Hi.
Possible.
So, it's your turn now.
Okay. My friends, I'm really very, very happy, and I know musicians don't like when conductor talks too much. I just want to say that terrible time. My last concert was in last March. Also, you see, and many concerts canceled. So let's be optimistic, and maybe one day we'll come to the new hall with a good acoustic. But now we have to do as much as possible, you see, and I hope we'll do a lot of music.
Vasilij Sinajský je rozhodně světová osobnost. Je to jeden z nejvýraznějších dirigentů, který s Janáčkovou filharmonií vystupoval a který s námi spolupracuje. V minulosti absolvoval spoustu výrazných dirigentských míst. Sám vzpomíná nejvíce na dlouhodobou pozici hlavního hostujícího dirigenta v BBC Philharmonic. Zároveň působil ve Velkém divadle v Moskvě, působil v různých orchestrech po celé Evropě.
Můžu říct, že první zkouška byla svým způsobem zničující, protože pan dirigent je až 73 letý, plný energie a elánu do práce. Byla to náročná, ale krásná zkouška.
Hudebně jsem strašně spokojen, že to je tak, jak bych si hudbu představoval dělat. A samozřejmě je to nový vztah hráčů s dirigentem, takže se musí najít ty mantinely a ta správná komunikace, ať vlastně ten výsledek je co nejlepší a vždycky pozitivní.
You see, every time when you have new position, and during my life I have several times, this possibility, of course, very tremendous, I can tell you. Very interesting, because you are looking forward and you think what I can do for this orchestra. And of course, musical tasks, because you must understand now orchestra more detailed. What is good, what is bad, who is better, who is not so great. And in this case, when you will build the program plan, special program, several programs, programs with guest conductors and your own programs, you must be more concentrated.
Obecně lze říci, že inklinuje k velkému romantickému repertoáru, inklinuje k velkému repertoáru 20. století, což zároveň považuji za zásadní přednosti tohoto orchestru. To znamená, v tomto je zde absolutní shoda.
Těším se na Stravinské osvěcení jara, protože to je prostě v lidově řečeno pecka. Ta skladba prostě vyvolává obrovské emoce.
When I just saw the announcement that we will play Rite of Spring, so I was a bit stressed because it's new conductor, really difficult piece for everybody because every instrument is very important there. I was just listening and reading the music score, but like the whole partiture, it's insane to read just my part. But fortunately, like the whole orchestra is so well prepared from the very first rehearsal, and conductor just could make a music.
Tak já jsem vlastně s novým panem šéf-dirigentem hrál minulý koncert, kde jsme hráli mimochodem i Sukovu pohádku, kde je krásné houslové solo. A co mě na tom bavilo, že pro něj to v těch 70 letech byla novinka a ohromně se tím bavil, těšil se té muzice a mě to přišlo velice dobré, velice inspirativní.
Richard Strauss is my favorite composer and we decide to be with this for the beginning. So we start with his famous piece, the Salome Dance, and then we'll do very interesting, his very last piece, his last composition, is four last songs. And second half, it's music of Stravinsky, who is of course not only Russian but international. The Rite of Spring, it's something like encyclopedia of everything for the orchestra. Everybody to play very well. Everything is clear. It is main stone of the repertoire in 20th century, and in very big style, very different style compared with Strauss. So it's not very, very easy. From my first day in the orchestra, I tried to explain them how to play Richard Strauss, how to play Stravinsky. But same time, I think for the audience, it should be also interesting. You see, I can tell you that when I was a young conductor, I liked concerts. Concert, it is the top and it is highest point. But now I am, of course, for me, very interesting what I will have as a result in concert. But process of preparation score, when you are going inside more and more, when you learn it with orchestra, you have to know it by heart and have it in your head, but also be very active with the orchestra to find some details for this group or for this instrument. It is also a very attractive process for me.
I think that Maestro has big experience, and I feel total respect for his knowledge, and I hope to learn a lot. But he is very demanding and he is very accurate, so we have to be focused all the time.
Puntičkař by se dalo říct, no, on prostě dovede vytáhnout z té hudební struktury věci, které by tam třeba člověk často netušil nebo si to neuvědomí. No. Dovede v tom tu mozaiku poskládat tak, že třeba skladba, která už zazněla mnohokrát, tak zazní svým způsobem zase jinak.
We met each other in school. We've been in the same class. So it was, I came to Tamara's class, then she and me were 14 years old. But it was just good friends, nothing. Yes, later we came together in conservatoire when we were 21, 22. Then we lived in Riga, and then I lived in Moscow. Tamara was also accompanist, you see, for them. And then we began to move too much. It was impossible for her. Sometimes you are coming. It's 4 days, yes? Concert. On Friday sometimes Wednesday. And then you must go with life for 1 day to Amsterdam. And because Monday morning usually start of the new program, we must fly on Sunday evening, you see. So we arrived to Amsterdam Saturday and fly next, completely new direction. Sometimes it's really terrible. But it's the life of all musicians, not only conductors.
Čus. Čau. Jo. Tak teď jsme právě v naší domácí hospůdce u Heitmana. Máme tady fantastického barmana Lukáše, který vlastně nás provází, nejenom jako nás provází šéfdirigent životem hudebním, tak nás provází pan Hachlice, nás tady provází životem nehudebním. Tady, jestli vidíte, máme svoji cedulku, kde sedáváme, teda už dlouho tam nesedáváme, ale přesto máme tady pamětní desku. A tady je to místo, kde po těch velkých koncertech a po těch vypjatých situacích se chodíme svlažit na mok dobrého piva, anebo si jenom popovídat o tom, co nás trápí a co nás čeká.
My plan is very, very easy to do. This orchestra is one of the best orchestras. Maybe not only Czech, but in Europe. I want this orchestra will be very famous and everybody knows Janáček Philharmonic. You have very good name here. In practice, everybody knows Janáček Philharmonic, but nobody knows why it is good. Now they have to understand that it's really good in many, many good things.
Myslím si, že od něho můžeme čekat v Ostravě velké věci a jsem velmi zvědav, jak se vyrovná zejména s českým repertoárem.
For me, it is absolutely new country, Czech Republic. I have a great love for the Czech music. All my life, my favorite composers, Janáček, Martinů, Dvořák, of course. So you see, I'm really happy, personally, to be in your city, to understand your atmosphere of life.